Hello everyone. The video conference meeting of the European Council was concluded after a single day of deliberation with a final statement adopted by the members of the European Council. Before going into what was agreed upon, first, let's talk a little bit about what the European Council actually is and what it does. It is the gathering of the heads of states and governments leading the executive branches of EU member states. The divergence is due to the specific national characteristics regarding the separation of powers. For instance, in France, the president is the main executive, while in Germany or Austria, it is the chancellor, and in Bulgaria or Portugal, it is the prime minister. So at these meetings, leaders of member states discuss the most relevant and pressing issues and set political guidelines regarding the future directions of the European Union. Contrary to common belief, the European Council does not actually legislate. This is left to the Council of the European Union, aka the gathering of respective ministers in different configurations, 10 to be exact. So what did they agree upon last week? Obviously, they have discussed COVID-19, but in this episode of Breakthroughs from Europe, I would like to focus on other topics that have not received so much spotlight in the press, such as digital policy and Russia. For instance, leaders stressed the pivotal role of digital transformation for European recovery and emphasized the need to enhance the EU's digital sovereignty, calling upon the Council and the Commission to take respective actions in the area of digital policy and speed up the respective decision-making processes. The Digital Services Act package is an important element to strengthen the single market for digital services, and leaders are counting on the co-legislators, ergo the Council and the European Parliament, to work and agree swiftly on this package. The digitalization of economies and the increasing number of digital operators in member states means that measures should be taken to ensure that these actors also pay their fair share of tax. Leaders voiced their preference for a global solution to the issue of digital taxation within the frameworks of the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development. But should talks stall in the OECD, they quasi-committed to move forward by mid-2021 on EU level. In light of the current low point in EU-Russia relationship, clearly illustrated at the press conference in Moscow between HRVP Borrell and Foreign Minister Lavrov, a strategic debate on Russia will take place at the next European Council meeting. Bearing in mind the current pandemic situation, this will most likely be held online again. According to the treaties, the European Council needs to meet at least 4 times a year. In this digital era we're living in, their next meeting could already take place as soon as in a few weeks' time. Thank you for joining me, and I look forward to giving you a glimpse of how the European Union works again soon.